free fluid in POD. So today we will be discussing what does it mean free fluid in POD. It's usually a sonographic finding. In the sonography of pelvis, many a times it is written free fluid is seen in POD. Or it may be a finding like minimal free fluid seen in POD. So what is POD? POD means pouch of Douglas. It is basically a space between the uterus and the rectum. It is a dependent space. We also call it as cul-de-sac. So what is free fluid in POD? Basically some amount of fluid in this pouch of Douglas. So why this free fluid occurs in POD? There are not many reasons behind this free fluid. There may be some reasons which are completely normal, that means physiological, you need not to do anything for them, and there are some pathological reasons, some diseases or some problems out of which this free fluid may appear. So coming to the physiological, first to the physiological causes. So it may normally be seen because of rupture of some follicles. Like when we do ultrasound in the mid-cycle, after ovulation, many a times we see minimal amount of small free fluid in POD, which is completely a normal thing and we need not to do anything for it. Second common cause, retrograde menstruation. Sometimes during the periods, because of retrograde menstruation, we see small amount of free fluid. Again, need not to be done with. Sometimes just because of increased level of estrogens, the ovarian permeability is increased. As a result of which we see some amount of free fluid in the pouch of Douglas. If you see some free fluid because of these reasons, then we really need not to do anything for the sake of free fluid in the pouch of Douglas. Right. Sometimes in pregnancy also, in 10 to 12% of the cases, it's an intrauterine pregnancy, no ectopic, no problem, but still we may find some amount of free fluid. But usually this free fluid is very small in quantity, usually less than 5 ml. We need not to do anything for this free fluid. Now coming to the pathological causes for this free fluid. So the most common cause is PID, that is pelvic inflammatory diseases. That is basically infection of the uterus and the fallopian tubes in the ovaries. But when we find PID, when we find free fluid in PID, there are other more symptoms which we see by which we can confirm that it is a case of PID or not. When we examine the patient clinically, we find that there is probe tenderness. By doing ultrasound, there is probe tenderness. On doing PV examination, we find tenderness on the movements of the cervix. There would be tenderness in fornices. Patient may complain of fever. There would be lower abdominal pain definitely. So PID, when free fluid with PID is there, then usually there are certain other symptoms, clinical features by which we can know that it is a case of PID, not a physiological one. Second common cause and one of the very greatest causes, the rupture ectopic pregnancy. That means the pregnancy was not inside the uterus, it was outside the uterus in the fallopian tubes or really the ovary, and that has got ruptured. As a result of which, blood is accumulated in the abdomen, and since POD or pouch of Douglas is a dependent area, so blood gets accumulated into that area. So in the case of rupture ectopic, we will definitely find free fluid in the pelvis, and definitely it has to be addressed urgently with surgery. Another important causes rupture tubovarian abscess. Sometimes there is significant infection and the tubovarian abscess gets ruptured. Sometimes some ovarian cyst gets ruptured. Sometimes we are treating the patient for infertility. We are giving them some injectables or ovulation inducing drugs. As a result of which, the ovaries get hyperstimulated. As a result of which also we find free fluid in the pelvis. We call the condition as ovarian hyperstimulation syndrome. In such cases also, we will find free fluid in the pelvis. Sometimes if a lady is having ascites, if there will be ascites, definitely there will be a lot of fluid in the peritoneal cavity, in the abdominal cavity, and also in the pouch of Douglas. So if ascites is there, in hydratiform mole also, which is not that common, molar pregnancy, in these cases also, we will find some free fluid in the pouch of Douglas. So basically, these are the pathological reasons. That means the causes for which you really need to be addressed. Sometimes the ovary gets torsion. Torsion of the ovary has some pre-existing cysto tumor and it has rotated on its own axis, and the torsion of the ovary is occurred. That will also give free fluid in the pelvis. So these are the pathological causes of free fluid in the pelvis, and we really need to address them. Usually, we are able to make the diagnosis with sonography, with clinical findings, with our perspectival and PV examination. Sometimes, when we have confusion and the picture is not clear, we may go ahead with the cryosynthesis. That means, we put a needle in the vagina. Through the vagina, we withdraw some amount of fluid and look for it, whether it is serous fluid or pus or blood, and this helps us in the diagnosis. So if you have free fluid because of any of these pathological causes, then definitely it needs to be addressed, and the treatment is completely dependent on the cause of the free fluid. But if you have just minimal free fluid in your sonography report, might be that you have gone to the sonography just out of some routine checkup and you don't have any symptoms, you don't have any lesion in the ovary or tubes, your report is just showing some free fluid in the pelvis. Not to worry for it, nothing to be done. If you have any confusion, you can write us down in the comment box section. Thank you.